There will be spoilers ahead for White Bear, and there will be spoilers for Black Mirror Seasons 1 through 2. In White Bear, we follow Victoria Scalane, who wakes up in a world where everyone is mindlessly filming on their smartphones as killers called hunters roam free. Victoria runs into Jim, who informs Victoria that a signal is causing everyone to become spectators. Jim brings Victoria to the White Bear radio tower so they can shut off the signal. At the radio tower, it's revealed that the entire day was made up. Victoria is a prisoner in something called a justice park. Victoria filmed her fiancé Ian Rennick kill a girl named Jemima Sykes. As a punishment, the park guests and employees recreate Victoria's crime by filming her torment. Every night, they wipe Victoria's memory of her day at the park. The next morning, she enters a park that's filled with reminders of her crime. Ian Rennick's tattoo became the logo of the White Bear Justice Park. In the narrative of the park, the symbol was being broadcasted on everyone's TVs, computers, and smartphones, and was supposedly making 9 out of 10 people into zombie spectators. The symbol also triggered flashbacks of her aiding in the kidnapping of Jemima Sykes. Victoria was given the photograph of Jemima that was used during the news coverage of her kidnapping. The name Jem is an abbreviation of Jemima. When Victoria stepped outside for the first time, for a brief moment, you could see a white teddy bear resting up against the fence, just like Jemima Sykes' teddy bear that was found after her disappearance. To be honest, it may even be the same one. Victoria filmed her fiancé torture and kill Jemima Sykes in the middle of the woods. So in the narrative of the Justice Park, Victoria is convinced to enter a van with two strangers, gets tied up in the middle of the woods, and is tortured while everyone films her without intervening. When in the woods, Victoria screamed for help and asked Baxter, "Why are you doing this to me?" They confused Victoria by wiping her memories and dropping her in this scenario. What was going through Victoria's mind was similar to what Jemima must have been thinking during her kidnapping, as Jemima was too young to fully understand what was happening to her. Jemima would have felt helpless and terrified, as well as confused that the only person who could help her was standing idly by filming. By the way, I wanted to quickly address the question, how is Victoria still alive? I've heard a lot of people ask this, and honestly, it's a good question. Victoria repeats the same day over and over again. So when does she have time to do things like eat, use the restroom, brush her teeth, etc., etc.? When she was in the van with Baxter and Jem, Victoria vaguely remembered certain aspects of her previous encounter with them. When Jem asked what was gonna happen next, Victoria said, "We eat." The next scene started with Victoria looking at that picture of Jemima while Jem was eating. Even though we never saw Victoria eat, it was implied that she finished eating when we first saw them in the woods. We also watched Victoria down a glass of water after waking up. Victoria was dehydrated after spending the previous day running, screaming, and crying. This dehydration worsened throughout the day, as Victoria had dry, chapped lips for the entire episode. They gave Victoria the bare minimum of what was needed to keep her alive. And I know most of you may be thinking, hold the pancakes, did he just introduce a bear pun counter? Yup. You know, given the subject matter and the fact that it's like day 200 of quarantine, I need this. Anyway, Victoria was absolutely helpless. She constantly screamed for help, but was too scared to try to rescue anyone else. In the convenience store, she watched Damien and Baxter fight over the shotgun. Instead of jumping in there, grabbing the gun, and saving Damien, Victoria just ran away. The only time Victoria took action was when she was told to do something, like grabbing the fire extinguisher, getting into a van with two strangers, or going to a radio tower she didn't want to go to. Victoria was passive and weak, the main reason she listened to every word Jem said, as Jem had a more commanding presence. When rewatching this episode, you begin to understand how much power someone like Ian must have had over Victoria. During the trial, Victoria claimed she was under Ian's spell, as she was pressured into helping him. Victoria's passive and submissive behavior played a huge role in her becoming an accomplice. In the narrative of the park, whoever had the shotgun was in a position of power. Baxter wielded the shotgun when he hunted Victoria and Jem. When he took Victoria and Jem hostage, Baxter was in control. When Jem snuck up, stole the shotgun, and shot Baxter, she gained back a position of authority. Later in the episode, the hunter with the welder mask had the shotgun. The other hunter tackled Jem and rendered her helpless. Once again, Victoria was put in a position where an innocent person was about to get killed in front of her. Victoria took the shotgun and reversed it on the hunter. She threw away this passive behavior and gained a position of power, showing us that Victoria was capable of change. But this progress was immediately interrupted by the stage opening up to an audience who were judging Victoria for her past wrongdoing. There's no rehabilitation or growth at the White Bear Justice Park. It's very clear Victoria was guilty. That part was not meant to be ambiguous. In the book Inside Black Mirror, the director of White Bear, Carl Tibbetts, commented on Victoria's punishment by saying, "It's not really about whether she's right or wrong. The piece is about not torturing people whether they've killed children or not. For me, the question of Victoria's guilt or innocence is slightly irrelevant." This episode wanted you, the audience, to focus more on how the park guests and employees treated Victoria. Everyone at the park was enraged and disgusted by how Victoria could film someone getting tortured without intervening. During Victoria's trial, the judge labeled her as a uniquely wicked and poisonous individual because she was an enthusiastic spectator to Jemima's suffering and actively reveled in her anguish. Yet the people at the White Bear Justice Park reveled in Victoria's anguish by becoming enthusiastic spectators to her suffering. In the book Inside Black Mirror, executive producer of the series, Annabelle Jones, claimed, "The focus is very much on how we bring people to justice, and what outrages we can do if we feel we're morally justified. Victoria committing that horrific crime was the thing that made people feel they could do whatever they wanted." It's safe to assume that anyone attending the park already knew the story of Victoria Scalane, because they spent the entire day filming her. So the only reason they played that news report was to remind Victoria of her crime, not to educate the audience. They've essentially turned a news report about a tragic incident into entertainment. The White Bear Justice Park is a manifestation of this mob mentality on social media, something that can be worsened by opinion journalism. I'm gonna sound so old when I say this, but most news nowadays is designed to make you angry, because nothing is more profitable than spreading fear and inciting anger. Certain news outlets can repeatedly dehumanize an individual until we see them as nothing but a monster. In the fictional narrative of the park, it's said that the radio signal has everyone mesmerized, indicative of how the media we consume through our TVs, computers, and smartphones can manipulate our emotions and enrage us, provoking us to go from an observer to a participant seeking our own form of justice. During the briefing at the beginning of the day, Jem and the other employees spoke about Victoria as if she was a violent criminal. Yet Victoria could barely defend herself in the park. Something that always stood out to me was how the judge said Victoria reveled in Jemima's anguish. To be fair, we never saw Victoria recording the video or the video itself. What we saw was Victoria's pain after she committed the crime, as she felt great remorse in the justice park to the point where she begged for death. At no moment did we witness Victoria getting any enjoyment from her crime. So I'm gonna go ahead and assume that the judge kind of made up the whole reveled in Jemima's anguish part, yet those words were selected to be part of a news report that was repeatedly played in the park. In this case, fact-checking or even questioning your source becomes unimportant since you've already been persuaded to view someone like this as subhuman. In this episode, we watch people who are so incredibly misguided in their attempt to do something good that they fail to recognize the hypocrisy of their own actions. Real justice is fair and objective, not bias and fun. The last and most important rule of the White Bear Justice Park is enjoy yourself. Like the news, they took a system that should be boring and turned it into something for their entertainment. The park guests go back on their own morals as they cheer on the oppressor. Victoria may have been under Ian's spell when committing her crime, but the park guests are under the media's spell when reenacting it. Everyone is caught in their own endless cycle of fear and hatred. We're not meant to side with Victoria, the employees, or the park guests. However, watching Victoria go through her punishment becomes pretty much unbearable. In the book Inside Black Mirror, Carl Tibbetts commented on the way Victoria was presented to us, saying, "As we experienced the park with her the first time around, we very much shot on handheld cameras, close to her, very intense and personal, one-on-one, making you feel you were her. For the majority of this episode, we didn't leave Victoria's side.
died.
We were shown intimate close-up shots of her face reacting to the post-apocalyptic world, while the park guests were told to keep their distance and use camera zoom. After the reveal, we didn't view a criminal like Victoria the same way we would if we were to read an article, view a status, or watch a news report about her crime. We saw Victoria's humanity and the audience's lack of it. So when you finish White Bear, ask yourself, did I enjoy the show?